Hi, welcome to Mappy Hour. We're here to talk about maps. We're going to get straight into it. Map number one, Edie.
First map is Ridgeline of the Sierra Divide by Joshua Flickinger.
It's pretty cool.
It's a really nice looking map, striking right off the bat.
I always go with this looks like the Very Hungry Caterpillar to start with.
It does.
Yeah, and his layout and composition is fantastic. And there's a lot of white space. Doesn't really need a border. Does a really good job there. And I like some of the really small little elements, like the typeface that he's used for the ridgeline, you know, for the title. Oh, I like this one. This is San Francisco Airport. This is Michael Hansen, Kelly Chung, Daisy Lewis, Eric Lang. And what I really like about this is it's really just data. Okay, the data just is the map.
Lots of pretty dots.
Well, that's all they've done. They've let the data just speak for itself. It's just colored.
But they're colored the way that the lights are actually colored, right?
Yeah. Yeah, all of the different runway lights, the sort of taxiways, the landside lights as well. It just makes a really pretty piece of data art.
I like how they've used like the dark theme base map behind it. It's nighttime, makes sense that the lights are on. Simple things.
Well, if you notice at the bottom, we've got the standard cartographic elements, a north arrow and a scale bar, so we can understand where we are. But if you notice, north is not directly up. They chose to orient it, so it's very geometric, which I think adds to that striking appeal.
What else do we have?
Let's see. Oh, this one I picked. This is Long Distance Dispersal of Violet Island's Arctic Foxes, and this is by Amanda Robinson. It tracks these Arctic foxes over about 14 years by satellite. Typically, Arctic foxes don't move around that much, but when their food is scarce, you know, you gotta find something to eat.
These are some busy foxes. They covered some ground.
So, I mean, look at the extent east-west of how far some of these foxes are moving. You know, we see the graticule. We've got over 100 degrees of longitude.
Yeah.
It's pretty impressive.
But I like the way in which the data sort of speaks for itself, because the background is very muted. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of visual hierarchy at play here. The data is the thing that you see first of all. And it is messy. Not all data has to be clean and perfect. They've just literally put the data on the map and it shows you everything you need to see.